Hello, I'm Brian Gaines, a developer in the Advanced Analytics Division and R&D at SAS. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the task in SAS Studio to quickly develop code for estimating a fully connected neural network with the power of SAS Viya. The structure of a neural network is inspired by the human brain in that it contains multiple layers of neurons and can learn complex relationships through training. The input layer contains your data set of interest, where each unit or neuron corresponds to a different variable or feature in your data set. To pass this information to a neuron in the next layer, the model takes a linear combination of the input variables and uses an activation function to transform it, often in a nonlinear way. This process is intended to resemble the firing of a neuron in your brain. After this is done for each neuron in the first hidden layer, these new values then become the inputs for the next layer, where this process is repeated. Eventually, the neurons in the last hidden layer are combined and transformed to generate the output. As an example, suppose you are interested in predicting the disease progression in diabetes patients using several baseline factors. We have data for 442 diabetes patients in 10 predictor variables, which include demographic information in addition to various health measures. I am using a small data set for the sake of this demonstration, but the process I am showing you is the same for much larger data sets, which you can handle with the distributed computing power of SAS Viya. Regardless of how large your data set is, the goal here is to build a model that lets you predict disease progression in diabetes patients. As I mentioned, I'm going to use the task in SAS Studio to perform this analysis with SAS Viya. If you are unfamiliar with SAS Studio, I encourage you to visit the SAS Studio product page to learn more about its array of productivity boosting features. After opening SAS Studio, to access the task, you click the task icon on the left and then expand the SAS task folder to display the task developed by SAS. As you can see, we've developed tasks that cover a wide range of analytical areas, including many for SAS Viya. Your ability to use these tasks will depend on your licensing. For this example, we are interested in the SAS Viya supervised learning category, so let's click to expand that, and then double-click to open the neural network task. This task, as well as the other Viya tasks, requires a connection to a SAS Cloud Analytics Services server, which I have already made. When you open a task, on the left you have the settings and options for the task, and at the bottom there is a task console that lists the items you must address before you can run the task. On the right, you have the work area, which initially consists of comments in the code because so far the minimum requirements for the task have not been met. The first thing you need to specify is your data set, so let's select the diabetes table that was already loaded into memory. When you're building a machine learning model, it is a good practice to use a validation set to tune the model and a test set to assess how the model might perform on new data. To do this, you first select validation data and test data, and then specify the proportion of your data to be allocated to those sets. Let's use 0.3 for the validation set and 0.1 for the test set. For the random number seed, let's use today's date. Now that your data are set up, you need to assign roles to the variables that will be used in your model. In this case, you're using an interval target, so let's select that. The target variable is the disease progression metric, which is labeled as Y in the data set, so let's select that. For the interval inputs or continuous predictors, you want to include all 10 remaining variables in your data set, so let's use this shortcut at the top to select all 10 predictors and then click OK. After making that selection, you can see that the code has been automatically generated in the code window since the task requirements are now met. You can see the target statement with Y as the target variable, in addition to an input statement with the variables that you just selected. Generally, the tasks are designed so that you need to make only a few selections to be able to run the task, but the task also provides you with a lot more options to customize the analysis. For example, on the Options tab, you have the ability to specify the network architecture. You can add hidden layers by clicking the plus button on the hidden layers table. Notice that after you do that, the code in the code window automatically updates in real time to reflect this change because there is now a second hidden statement corresponding to a second hidden layer. This automatic code generation can be a useful tool for learning SAS syntax. You can also specify the number of neurons in each hidden layer, and you can choose between 7 different activation functions. For now, let's stick with the defaults and click Submit to run the task. In the results, let's scroll down to see how the model performed on the validation set. Using the naive network architecture, the mean square error on the validation set is well over 5,000, which is not very good for this data set. Although neural networks are very flexible and powerful models, one of the biggest challenges with them is specifying the architecture and some of the other optimization options or the hyperparameters. This can be painstakingly done through a lot of trial and error, but fortunately SAS has something called Autotuning that can help you with this. Autotuning uses an intelligent optimization-based approach to help you find good values for your hyperparameters. At the top of the Options tab, let's select Automatically Tuned Selection Options to enable Autotuning. You can tune the number of hidden layers in the model and the number of neurons in each hidden layer. One nice thing about Autotuning is that you can use your domain expertise and other information specific to your problem to impose constraints that guide Autotuning to consider only certain values for the hyperparameters. For example, suppose for some reason you would like for the final model to have at least two hidden layers. You can enforce this by increasing the initial value in the lower bound to 2. Let's also increase the upper bound to 5. Let's use the default values for the number of neurons per layer. In the optimization section, you have the ability to auto-tune the hyperparameters that govern the L1 and L2 regularization terms. Let's also stick with the default values for those options. The auto-tune settings option contains various options that let you control how the auto-tuning is performed, but again, let's use the defaults. Since auto-tuning trains the model for many different combinations of your tuning parameters, this process can take significantly longer than training a single model. Instead of waiting for the code to run, let's jump ahead and look at results I saved when I did this earlier. Let's scroll down to see the auto-tuning results. The second auto-tuning table displays the results using the initial values for the tuning parameters in addition to the 10 combinations of the hyperparameters that resulted in the best mean square error on the validation set. For example, a network architecture with 9 neurons in the first hidden layer, 14 in the second layer, and a small value for the L2 regularization parameter resulted in a validation error of about 2,600. This is about half of the error you saw when using the initial model. Auto-tuning is a great feature that makes it easier to build your model by automatically finding good values for your hyperparameters. As you can see, the task in SAS Studio enable you to quickly and easily develop code for building a traditional neural network model. For more information, please visit the SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning product page and the SAS Studio Task Reference Guide. Thanks for watching.